In the previous lecture, I talked about some of the rules of the passive voice. So I also discussed how to change the sentences from active into passive. Today, I'll discuss some of the rules how to change the sentence from active into passive. So all the rules I'll try to discuss here. So first rule. Subject becomes object, because in passive voice we have to write the sentence which starts with object. So when sentence comes, so this sentence is related to the active voice. So he writes a letter. So this sentence start with subject, but when we change this sentence into passive voice, so subject becomes object and object becomes subject. So it is the second rule. So first rule is what? Subject becomes object and object becomes subject. Now if the sentence has many objects and different type of the words are used, so from this type of the complex sentence, how to find the object? And from any sentence there is one key to find the object. How to find the object? So to find the object, we have to ask question to ourselves by using what and whom. So if we ask question by using what and whom, what we will get? We will get object here. In this sentence, we just see he writes a letter. He writes what? So what he writes? He writes a letter. So a letter is our object. Then next, what we have to do? As per the rule, write two be verbs of tense. Two be verbs. The sentence is related to the present tense. If present tense is given, so two be verbs of the present tense are am, is, and are. So we just follow the rule. So first we write object here. A letter is singular, so in present tense with later we can write is. A letter is. Then what to do? We have to write the past participle of verb. Past participle, the main verb write is written here, right? So we have to write the third form of the write. So a letter is written. The next step, what we have to do? We have to write by preposition. A letter is written by, then subjective pronoun he is given. So in the previous lecture, what I taught, subjective pronoun will be converted into the objective pronoun. So objective pronoun of the he is him. So a letter is written by him. So in this way, we can change the sentence from active into passive. So a letter is written by him, it's a passive sentence, and he writes a letter, it's an active sentence. The next one, they did their work. So what they did? So we have just found our object, their work. So their work we have to write in the place of subject, their work. We have to find out about the tense. Is simple past tense. So simple past tense, to be verbs of the simple past tense are was and were. That word is a singular, so we can write that word was. Did verb is given, the main verb did is given, so third form of the did, done we have to write, that word was done, then by preposition, and the subjective pronoun is given. So the subjective pronoun will be converted into them. So it is related to the simple present tense and simple past tense. In simple present tense, am is are, past participle, by preposition we have to write, and in past tense, simple past tense, was were, past participle, by preposition, and if subjective pronoun is given, it will be changed into the objective pronoun. If noun is given, if any person's particular name is given, so we don't have to make change in it. Next one, it is related to the continuous tense. If any continuous tense, whether it is present continuous tense or past continuous tense, if continuous tense is given, we have to add been to remove ing. And if ing is removed, the verb, we can convert the verb into the root form and it will be changed into the past participle. So the present continuous tense and past continuous tense sentences are given, so we have to add been to make it passive. So third sentence, I am playing cricket. What I am playing? So cricket. So cricket, it is our object. Cricket we have to write. With cricket, am is not written. So am is are means to be verbs of the present tense. So is suitable here. Cricket is. Now ing is given. So that's why we have to remove this ing. So how to remove? We have to write being over here. Now it becomes only play. Now we have to write the past participle of the play, being played, then by preposition and subjective pronoun I is given, so we have to write me. So we can write like this, cricket is being played by me. If past continuous tense means he was doing his work, so was doing his work, it's a past continuous tense, so we can change the sentence like this, his work was being done by him. But future continuous tense has no passive formation and no passive change, so we don't have to think about the future continuous tense. Now the another rule, if any perfect tense, whether it is present perfect tense, past perfect tense and future perfect tense, we have to add been to make it passive. We don't have to write the past participle of the verb because past participle is already given in the perfect tense. So this sentence is for future perfect tense. I will have finished my work before 12 noon. So what I will have finished? So my work, that object we have just found here. So we have to write my work in the place of subject, my work, then will. In this we don't have to make any change. We have to write will, then we have to write have, then after have we have to add been as per the rule. My work will have been. We finished, the past participle is already given, finished, then by preposition, and what subjective pronoun is given, it will be changed into the objective pronoun. So me, so my work will have been finished by me. So will we have to write, then we have to write have, then after have we have to add been, and the past participle which is already given in the sentence, that we have to write, then by preposition and subjective pronoun will be changed into the objective pronoun. What about the modal verbs? If any modal verb is given, like can, could, would, should, have to, has to be to, so this type of the modal verbs are given, so we have to add only be. And third form of the verb we have to write, and in this way we can change the sentence from active into passive. So we see here, he will help you. So he will help whom? So you is our object. So you have to write you here, you will, then after will we have to write be, then third form of the verb means past participle, helped by, then he is given, so subjective pronoun changes into the objective pronoun and we have to write him. So in this way we can make change. So what we have understood here, in simple present tense and simple past tense we have to write to be verbs as per the tense and write the past participle of the verb, and by preposition we have to write. If any perfect tense is given, we have to add been, and write the past participle of the verb. Then if any modal verb is given, we have to add be and past participle of the verb and any continuous tense, whether it is present continuous tense and past continuous tense. We have to add being and write the past participle of the verb plus by preposition we have to write, and in this way we can make the change and convert the sentence from active into passive. Thank you.